Welcome to the Essential Ideas of David Hume. One of Hume's most lasting contributions is his warning against allowing politicians to finance their spending through debt. Hume argued that public debt ultimately leads to ruin, both because it allows politicians to provide benefits to voters today at the expense of the next generation, and because debt can threaten a country's sovereignty if the borrowing is financed by foreigners. Let's explore each of these warnings with an example. Politicians in the made-up country of Debtland promise an expensive new government program at no cost to voters today, because all of the new program's cost will be paid for by borrowing. Enough voters like the idea of the new program to elect the politicians. But what the politicians didn't tell the voters, and what the people who supported the expensive program failed to understand, is that the next generation will bear the cost of the program. Hume saw this as an inappropriate use of government power to grant benefits to people today at the expense of the next generation, who have no say in the decision. In other words, the next generation is being handed a bill for something they don't benefit from and had no voice in approving. But Hume also warned that it wasn't just immoral to provide benefits today at the expense of the next generation. Public debt can also weaken a nation's sovereignty. Back to our example. Let's say Debtland is in trade negotiations with Prudentia, a country that's been financing most of Debtland's borrowing over the years. Prudentia and Debtland do not enter the trade talks as equals because Debtland is beholden to Prudentia to continue financing its borrowing. It was for these reasons that Hume wrote, "Either the nation must destroy public credit, or public credit will destroy the nation." A warning that is just as relevant today as it was 250 years ago in Hume's time. For more information on David Hume, visit essentialhume.org. And to learn about more essential scholars, visit essentialscholars.org.